Hi students, welcome to my YouTube channel Lokesh Gupta Chemistry Classes. Today our topic is solutions for JEE Mains 2020 January spell. Now today I am going to give solutions for two chapters from the physical chemistry, structure of atom or atomic structure, and second chapter states of matter, that is gaseous state. Now come to explain one by one. First question, it is given in January 7th forenoon. What is the question? The number of orbitals associated with the quantum numbers n equal to 5, principal quantum number n equal to 5, ms, spin quantum number equal to plus half. What they want? Number of orbitals with the quantum number n equal to 5. See, in the given orbit, nth orbit, maximum number of possible subshells or maximum number of possible L values, each L value indicates one subshell, equal to n. Next, maximum number of possible orbitals or maximum number of possible magnetic quantum number m values equal to n square, or you can write in this way also, that same formula you can write in this way also. Next, maximum number of possible electrons, maximum number of possible electrons equal to 2n square. Out of 2n square, n square electrons, spin quantum number plus a half, spin quantum number minus a half, spin quantum number minus a half. Now the same formula you can write in this manner also. Now what is our question? Number of orbitals with the quantum number 5. So in the fifth orbit, 2 into 5 square, 25 orbitals are possible. See, in every orbital, one electron with the clockwise spin, one electron with the anti-clockwise spin possible. So with this quantum number, how many orbitals possible? 2 into 5 square, 50 electrons possible. In that 25 orbitals, 50 electrons. So our question is, our answer is 5 square, 25 is the answer. 25 orbitals, in that 25 orbitals, 50 electrons. 50 electrons, for 25 electrons spin plus a half, for 25 electrons spin minus a half. Next, come to the next question. It is given in 8th January afternoon. See, the radius of the second Bohr orbit in terms of the Bohr's radius A0 in lithium 2 plus. So what they want? Second Bohr orbit radius in lithium 2 plus ion in terms of Bohr's radius A0. They want this one. Now what is the formula for radius of the nth orbit? N square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. If you substitute the constant values, 0.529 into n square by z, angstrom units. Now, radius of the first orbit in the hydrogen atom, 0.529 angstrom units. We take that one as Bohr's radius. So now you can write it as A0 into n square by z angstrom units. N, principal quantum number. Z, atomic number of that uni electron spaces. Now see, second orbit to lithium 2 plus na. So radius of second orbit in lithium 2 plus ion, A0 into second orbit. So n value 2, 2 square 4 by lithium, lithium plus, lithium 2 plus. Atomic number will not change, 3 only. 4 A0 by 3. So our answer is second option. Now come to the next question. The de Broglie wavelength of the an electron in the fourth orbit, in the fourth Bohr's radius orbit. So what they want? Fourth Bohr orbit, in that de Broglie wavelength they want. That is our question. Now here we know that circumference of the nth orbit, circular na, circumference 2 pi r equal to n lambda, means in the nth orbit, electron makes n waves. In the first orbit, in one complete revolution, electron makes one wave. In second orbit, in one complete revolution, it makes two waves. In fourth orbit, in one complete revolution, first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave. So, it is called constructive interference or wave in phase. So, circumference equal to n lambda. Now, fourth orbit wavelength we want. Now, 2 pi into radius of the fourth orbit we know. Rn directly proportional to n square norm. First orbit radius a0 in hydrogen. In hydrogen, fourth orbit radius 4 square, 16 a0. N value 4, lambda 4. Therefore, lambda 4 equal to 8 pi a0. 8 pi a0, second option. Now, one more question also given from the atomic structure. Let me write that question. Next question from atomic structure. For the Balmer series, in the spectrum of a hydrogen atom, wave number nu bar equal to Rydberg-Konstant for hydrogen into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. The correct statements among 1 to 4 are 4 statements given. These are the 4 statements. First statement, as wavelength decreases, the lines in the series converge, means merges, gap decreases. Second statement, the integer N1 value, that is lower energy level N1, is equal to 2. Next, the lines of longest wavelength corresponds to the higher energy level N2 equal to 3. Next, the ionization energy of hydrogen can be calculated from the wave numbers of these lines. These lines means Balmer series lines. It is the question. This question gave 8th January forenoon. Okay, now come to explain one by one point. Now, when electron jumps from higher energy level to first energy level, then you will get the spectral lines in Lyman series. When electron jumps from higher energy level to second energy level, then you will get the spectral lines in Balmer series. So, lower energy level, N1 value 2 for Balmer series. So, second statement correct. Next. Now, first line in the Balmer series. When electron jumps from third orbit to second orbit, you will get the first line in Balmer series. For that, it is the amount of energy released. Next, for the second line, beta line in Balmer series. Now, fourth to second electron jumped. Now, energy of the electron, released energy will increase. So, when compared with the first spectral line, for second spectral line, energy increasing. So, with increasing the N2 value of the spectral line, energy of the spectral line increasing. Energy increasing means wavelength decreasing. Wavelength decreasing. See, what they said, the line of longest wavelength, wavelength inversely proportional to energy, longest wavelength, so least energy spectral line, 322, first line, H alpha line in Balmer series. So this statement also correct. For the first line, energy least to wavelength highest. For the last line, that is limiting line, infinity to 2. For that, energy highest to wavelength least. Next. Now come to this point and see. With increasing the N value, energy difference between the successive energy levels decreasing. With increasing the N value, energy difference between the successive energy levels decreasing. As a result, with increasing the N2 value of the spectral line, N2 value of the spectral line, the successive lines energy difference will decrease. Successive lines energy difference decreases. If energy difference of the spectral lines is more, in between the spectral lines gap will be more. Next, If energy difference of the spectral line or wavelength difference of the spectral line is less, then gap between the spectral lines will be less. Now see, so with increasing the energy or with decreasing the wavelength, what happens? Energy difference between the spectral lines decreasing. So wavelength difference decreasing. So these spectral lines comes very close to each other. So this statement also correct. As the wavelength decreases, what is happening? Energy difference between the successive energy levels decreases. As a result, wavelength difference between the successive spectral lines also decreases. See, Balmer series lines observed in visible region. First line, red in color. Second line, green. Third line, blue. Fourth line, violet colored spectral line. Okay. Now come to the third statement also correct. Now come to the fourth statement. The ionization energy of hydrogen can be calculated from the wave numbers of these lines. These lines means Balmer series. It is the wrong statement. See, what is the ionization energy of hydrogen? It is the amount of energy required to remove the electron from the first orbit of hydrogen
to infinity.
Now that energy will be equal to the energy of which spectral line in hydrogen atom? Infinity to 1. That is limiting line in Lyman series. Limiting line in Lyman series. That spectral line energy will be the hydrogen ionization energy. In any uni-electron species, ionization energy equal to energy of the spectral line of which spectral line? Limiting line in Lyman series. So they said here Balmer series. So wrong. So first three statements are correct. So what is the answer? First option is the answer. So atomic structure, four questions over. Now let me explain the questions from gaseous state, states of matter. The relative strength of inter-ionic or intermolecular forces in decreasing order is, they gave this question 7th morning, 7th forenoon. See, here what is the correct order? See, with increasing the magnitude of the charge, force of attractions, interactions will increase. In case of ions, complete 1 unit positive charge, 1 unit negative charge are 2 units, 2 1 units will be there. In case of dipoles, partial charges only will be there. So, what will be the correct answer? We have to answer based on the quantity of the charge, magnitude of the charge. See, ion-ion greater than, ion-dipole greater than, dipole-dipole attractions. So, correct answer is fourth option. Now, come to the next question. The predominant intermolecular forces present in ethyl acetate, a liquid R. What are the predominant forces? What are the options? Dipole-dipole and hydrogen bonding. London dispersion and dipole-dipole. London dispersion, dipole-dipole and hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding and London dispersion. These are the options given. See, it is the ethyl acetate structure. For this, dipole moment are not equal to zero. It has some dipole moment. It is polar molecule now. So in between the polar molecules, they have permanent dipole moment now. So dipole-dipole attractions will be there. But students, one point. In between two molecules of any type, compulsorily van der Waals forces, that is London dispersion forces, will be present compulsory. So in between the ethyl acetate molecules in the liquid state along with the common force, London dispersion forces. Next, now additionally here, since it is polar molecule, dipole-dipole attractions present. So answer is 2. So for example, if you take carbon dioxide, for this dipole moment to zero, it is non-polar. It is non-polar. So in between the CO2 molecules, only London dispersion forces only will be present. Only will be present. Next, if you take noble gas, argon dissolved in the water. Noble gas, argon dissolved in the water. Now see, argon dissolved in the water. For this argon, no dipole moment. No dipole moment. So it is non-polar molecule. Water. Water has some permanent dipole moment. Water has some permanent dipole moment. Now this water will induce some dipole moment in this. This water molecule will polarize. Will polarize. This positive part of the water will attract the electron cloud of argon. Electron cloud of argon. So as a result, in this some dipole moment polarized. So it is induced dipole. It is permanent dipole. So in between them, which forces present? Induced dipole, dipole attractions. So noble gases are very less soluble in water because of induced dipole, dipole attractions. Of course, in between these two, commonly London dispersion forces, that is Van der Waals forces, also present commonly. So in the January spell, they given more number of questions from intermolecular forces only. So during your revision, better to focus on the intermolecular forces. So don't leave single word also from the NCERT. Read each and every line. Next, let me write the next question is, identify the correct labels of A, B and C in the following graph from the options given below. What is the graph? Number of molecules versus speed. Actually, small mistake is there in this graph. Number of molecules is not correct. Fraction of the molecules better to say. Fraction of the molecules better to say. But they give like that. Better to say velocity instead of the speed. Better to say velocity. Okay, leave that one. Now come to the solution. What is the formula for most probable velocity? Root over 2RT by M. Average velocity, root over 8RT by pi M. RMS velocity, root over 3RT by M. So from this, which velocity value is more? RMS velocity greater than, average velocity greater than, most probable velocity. So it is the ratio of these three velocities. Better to by heart these ratios. So most probable velocity value less. So A is most probable velocity. Next more value, average velocity. Next more value, RMS velocity. So what is the correct answer? Option A, most probable velocity, average velocity, next RMS velocity. So it is the answer. Now let me explain some more points. So in terms of velocity value, in terms of velocity, most probable velocity less than the average velocity, less than the RMS velocity. Now, in terms of the fraction of the molecules, in terms of a fraction of the molecules, maximum fraction of the molecules possess most probable velocity. Next to maximum fraction of molecules possess average velocity, average velocity. Next, RMS velocity, less fraction of the molecules. It is the fraction of the molecules. Of course, it is not related to the question. That question solution over. I want to give some more explanation. Next, if you increase the temperature for given sample, if you increase the temperature, how this graph will change? With increasing the temperature, curve becomes wide. Curve becomes wide. Next, height of this peak will decrease. Height of this peak will decrease. Next, see, with increasing the temperature, Cp value will increase. But fraction of the molecules with that Cp value will decrease. Next, with increasing the temperature, fraction of the molecules with less velocity decreases, but fraction of the molecules with high velocity increases. Next, in this graph, area under the curve gives the total number of molecules in the sample. Now, for the same sample, we increase the temperature from T1 to T2. Now, with the temperature, shape of the curve changing, it becoming flat, height of the peak decreasing. But at all the temperatures for the given gas sample, area under the curve will not change. So, students, better to focus on the intermolecular forces and molecular velocities from these states of matter. Of course, not only these two subtopics, you have to revise the total chapter. So, students, today two chapters solution over. In the next video, I am going to do on the solutions for stoichiometry chapter. Stoichiometry chapter solution in the next video I am going to do. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon to get all my notifications. Bye, students. And one more point, students. For this also, I am going to give the assignment. Now, I give an assignment. So, all of you solve that assignment. Bye, students. We'll meet again.